One of the most powerful films you'll see this year is called Prisoners. It stars Hugh Jackman as a man whose six-year-old daughter is kidnapped, and Jake Gyllenhaal, who's the cop who must find her. It's a film that leaves you asking what you would do if you're in the same situation. Jake Gyllenhaal thoroughly researched his role, discovering the role of interrogation in child abductions and learning to play his complicated character.
Dad, there was this RV and they were playing on it. We thought there was someone inside.
You wait here.
Let me go.
I couldn't find them.
911.
Detective Loki.
Do you have children, Detective?
I'm going to find your daughters.
Jake, great to see you. Congratulations on what is an incredibly powerful role in an incredibly powerful film. Going in, what were your thoughts? What sort of headspace did you have to be in to tackle this?
Well, it's a difficult subject matter, definitely. But I think for me, what was interesting about it was kind of knowing that the character had to walk both lines and be fascinated on both sides. You know, to play a detective is one thing, but somebody who I think is good at their job in that sphere of work has to be fascinated with the mind of the suspect and at the same time desperately want to solve the crime and care for the people who've been affected by it. So to walk that line, I think, is a fascinating thing as an actor to play. And I think, as I witnessed through a lot of research, a very difficult thing for the people who do it in real life to do.
There's no way that someone with the IQ of a 10-year-old could abduct two girls in broad daylight and then somehow make them disappear.
Well, maybe he wasn't on his own. How could he drive an RV if he has an IQ of a 10-year-old?
Hey, we're considering all possibilities.
I don't think you are considering all possibilities.
I hear what you're saying.
No, listen to me. Just shut up for a second.
This is what I'm going to need you to do for me. I need you to calm down, Mr. Dover. I understand this is an incredibly hard time, but I have every uniformed police officer in this state looking for Anna.
I don't understand what any of this means. They said he ran. They said he tried to get away. I don't understand why he would try to run away.
I hear what you're saying. I'm not crossing anybody off my list.
So you spoke to policemen who've dealt with these sort of cases. Does it really, I mean, you couldn't go home and forget about what you're doing during the day when you're dealing with a missing child?
Well, in real life, I don't think you ever stop until, you know, hopefully the crime is solved. But I think, and yes, I think that's deeply affecting. I mean, I have done a lot of research and spent a lot of time with law enforccement. I had made this movie, End of Watch, where I played a police officer. Actually, it was the movie I've done right before this. And so I know a lot of police officers. And then in the research for this film, it got even more extensive. And I talked to many detectives, but particularly watched a lot of interrogations, hours, hundreds of hours of interrogations of suspects. And you can just see, you know, that the surgery that it takes to sort of unlock an admission, sometimes that admission is not always true, which is interesting too. In this world of human behavior, you know, when you're a first responder as in law enforcement, you're dealing with that moment where it is so intense and it's extraordinary in one way. But then as a detective, you know, you're dealing with human behavior and the minutiae and trying to solve the truth, whatever that might be, and it is elusive. So to me, that's what was fascinating about the entire, it's what's fascinating about this movie, because that's really what I think this movie's about. But it was fascinating about doing the research too.
Where they are? I want to talk. He's a free man. I'm a free man. Hey! Tell me what's the deal with him?
They didn't cry until I left them.
What did you say? What did you say?
How did you find working with Hugh Jackman?
You know, he's difficult, and I really feel like people have the wrong impression of him.
You mean all this nice guy stuff? Garbage?
I feel like the many, many years, maybe decades now, that he's been known as some nice guy, I'm here to break open and just let you know that I feel like it's just all a huge performance, and it's not true at all. He's a horrible man with really bad intentions, and I...
truth revealed at
honestly
last.
It's annoying to me how good this man is. He is legitimately an honest guy, and for me, you know, I really look up to that. I believe in any business that the way you treat people and the excitement and your work ethic and the intensity with which you approach your work is infectious, and it is really a key to success. And I mean that creatively. And between the two of us, he was always open, always humble, even in his position. And I loved working with him. And it annoys me still.
Every day she's wondering why I'm not there. Me, not you, not you. But me!
What in the world did you do?
Someone has to make him talk, or they're gonna die. You have to know someone, and he knows where this guy is.
Why aren't you telling me?
This ain't right.
Why?
This guy's a fake. The girls are still out there.